Alien Rifle Range Sunday. I have a Savage Model 11. I went through this gun about 2 years ago. That's a Bell & Carlson stock. Black paint job, about four coats of clear. Model 11. Receiver. Bottom bolt release. If you're going to do a rehab on one of these, I would recommend you get the top bolt release. It's just going to be easier to work with. It's a Schilling 1/8 twist barrel, 26-inch, Witt machine muzzle brake. Tames this 260 Remington down to about less than a 6BR right now. It's a Citron 8-32x56. Just really like these scopes. Probably best in class for value in my mind, but there are many good scopes out there. This gun, this chamber has a peculiar issue with a very short lead. When I shoot the 140 grainers, the bullets are seated so far back into the case, it just doesn't seem right. So what we're doing today is we're using 123 grain Sierra Match Kings and Hodgdon 4350. We're starting with a charge of 42 grains and we're working our way up to 44 grains. 44 grains of Hodgdon 4350 with that 123 grainer give you about 3,000 feet per second. These are 100 yard groups starting with 41.5 grains, 42 grains, 42.5, 43, starting to see some promise there, 43.5. 43.7 and 44. Now, kind of tough decision because the wind is blowing between 10 and 15 miles an hour. I know at 100 it shouldn't make a big deal, but I'm either going to load 44 grains or 43 grains. The fact that I've got three with very little stringing there in that one hole, and then at the other one there's two. I might try the 44. In the comments, if you want to tell me which one you would use. Would you use 43 or would you use 44?